Today on Attack of the Show, the battle has begun. The PS3 and Wii go head-to-head in the loop. Some love it, others hate it. We take a closer look at the PlayStation 3 on Game Break. All this and more on a live and feisty Attack of the Show, starting right now.
What's going on here?
Attack. Pick up on this.
Attack of the Show. Attack.
Attack of the Show, TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. It's Monday, November 13th. It's going to be a long week, a busy week. My name is Kevin Pereira.
It's going to be a great week.
It's an amazing week.
Hey, guys, I'm Olivia Munn, and we are coming to you live from the G4 Studios in L.A.
And the reason we're so excited, really, the official countdown has begun for the console wars.
Mm-hmm. Mm. This Friday, the PS3 will be released, and then 2 days later, the Wii will also hit shelves.
Whee! That means a week from today, both systems are going to be out. The wait is almost over, and now that we're actually this close, it's going to get ugly.
Going to get very ugly. The battle is raging. People are going nuts. It is time for
Console Wars 06 Live! I'm going wild.
Woo!
Listen to that. Yeah, I still fine hangovers.
We're excited.
Oh, yeah, of course. On Saturday, Japan was really the site of the official PlayStation 3 launch. 100,000 consoles went on sale. Really wasn't that many. They're gone. They're always gone, of course. Crowds were already lining up days ahead of time, but once the doors open, all that customary politeness and order, it just started to crumble.
Yes, and then all hell broke loose. According to numerous blogs, Chinese immigrants and homeless people were paid to wait in line, and people working for the Yakuza bought a huge number of systems who will sell them for triple the price.
Right. I mean, I use 4 day laborers. They're in line at Best Buy at Westwood right now.
Are they?
Yeah.
Could you get me
one? Pennies on the dollar.
Could you get
Absolutely.
Me a Wii?
Now, again, gamers get screwed. The real people who want the consoles and want to play the games can't get their hands
on
it.
Yes, but now, from the videos we are about to show you, at least one PS3 won't be making it to eBay. Yeah, some Japanese guys were lucky enough to get one and then decided to dissect it like a frog in science class. No hamster wheel inside. It's actually a well-put-together piece of hardware.
Yeah, it took them like 5 minutes to get the case off the thing, but they uncovered the cell processor, the fan, which keeps it all cool somehow.
And quiet.
That's the amazing part. But the best part of the PlayStation 3 is that it's going to be like a hack fest. People have already swapped out the hard drives for bigger ones. The software is pretty much open source. People are saying you can install your own operating systems onto the thing, so at least right now it sounds like Sony's like, hey, you know what, you spent $700,
do what you want. It's yours.
Yeah.
Now, all right, enough with PS3 news. There's another console coming, and it is the Nintendo Wii. We have one, and we're going to play it when? Right now.
Yeah, we've actually been rushing through most of the show consciously
to get
right here. So for those of you who have been sleeping under a pile of rocks for like the last few months, here's how the thing works.
Yes.
Why don't you grab your remote there, sweetheart. This is the Wiimote and nunchuck attachment here.
Yes, it's all sensor.
All runs off Bluetooth. You got to put on the wrist strap.
Because
it could go flying across the room and kill a house cat.
Or screw the cat. I don't want to break my remote.
That too.
You
don't want to break the remote. So we've got a plasma over here with the sensor bar, which can detect the remotes, 10 meters away.
Which is really
hanging out.
We're probably like about like a meter and something away.
Give or take. I think the average distance for most gamers. And you can have up to 4 controllers connected wirelessly. It's got some GameCube controller ports in there. But what's great is that it comes packaged with a game.
Yeah. Now, when you guys buy the system, you actually get a game with it. Wii Sports is inside the box, and it's probably the first thing that people will play. So we decided that we would fire up this bad boy and give you a preview of what's in store. There's 5 different sports to play, but Kevin and I, we're going to box.
Yeah. I know. I've been wanting to punch you in the face for like the last year and a half.
Go ahead.
And now we have the chance to really make it happen.
I'm excited.
So we got the game fired up here. We're going to go into it, and it's going to give you a little tutorial. Now, again, it's not like, okay, let me explain to you 12 different buttons that you need to know for all these different things. You see your character reflected on the screen. Now, if you tilt the remote to the left or right, you'll see that your character also does that as well.
Yeah.
Raise your hands up. You're going to block your face. Keep them down. You're going to block the body. And then, okay. All right. I was demonstrating the body block, and now you're going to town.
That's very classic.
I love that you don't have to push any buttons. You just get to.
No, you look like you're doing some Tai Bo, body boot camp. What are you doing? What's the workout you've been doing lately?
Boot camp. Barry's boot camp.
Barry's boot camp.
Every morning at 7 a.m.
And as you can see, like the remote has a built-in speaker, so with each punch that I throw, I actually get to hear the leather that Olivia's eating. It's fantastic.
And it vibrates whenever you get knocked.
Right. Throw hooks, throw uppercuts. I think you can rabbit punch. If you want, I could actually grab like Tyson and pull into the ear bite.
Do that.
Hold on, I gotta get in there.
Hold on, I'll stay still.
But it's really cool. No, you can't. There's no ear biting, unfortunately. It'd be a nice feature. But there you go. And look at the cute little characters, Mom.
I know. I love it how like there's different characters you can pick from, and that one looks like me.
Well, no. It doesn't just look like you. It is you. This is the coolest thing about it. Notice, by the way, the little hand, it even tilts.
Oh, yeah, and then we can tilt in with each other.
We'll get to the main menu and we can do that. It's really cute. But what's great is that you take it out of the box. Everybody's like, play a game. Why don't you play Zelda? You know, play some Wii Sports. I spent 10 minutes making my Mii, which is a virtual version of yourself that you can use in all the games.
Well, no, I have to stop you here. I noticed that they're all called channels. We were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, very smart move by Nintendo for that. You know, people who aren't used to video gaming, they can pick this up and go, oh, different channels.
So user-friendly.
There's a game channel. Yeah. There's a sports and news. And so here we can go into the Mii creator, and these are all of the character. Oh, here we go.
So I gotta tell everybody, when Kevin first opened up the game, he didn't go play the games. He instead made a bunch of Miis.
Yeah.
He made his whole family and friends and everybody.
There's Kristen Holt hanging out. I actually didn't make that
with the goatee. Hey, you got a goatee.
And then check this out here. Let me grab this little girl. Oh, look at her squirm. That's like when I grab a fistful of her hair in real life. Slam her against the screen a couple times. Take out some aggression.
You leave little Olivia Mii alone.
No. I made this virtual version of you. You can spit
with
it around.
With freckles.
Isn't that cute? But we could go, and if you don't like that, you want like a botched makeup job, a little Tammy Faye.
Oh, I like the green one.
Going on there. We can change your
can
hair
I have longer hair?
Yeah, we could do that. Let's get you some better
can
hair.
Can I have my freckles back?
Done. I'll get you your freckles back. But you see, you could spend hours literally making yourself and your friends. And if you've got a Mii, or if you've got a Wii, and I have one as well, we can connect to each other wirelessly over the internet.
Yeah.
And you can hang out on my virtual console.
And then you can do a Mii parade. And you get all your friends, you can march down.
Yeah.
Have a Mii parade.
They'll actually throw a parade. I'm so excited for this thing. It's fun.
Sick.
It's intuitive. Within 3 seconds, you're picking up and you're playing it.
Hey, Nintendo, send us some for free. But you guys at home, we're sorry if we made your wait worse. We apologize.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Kill some time at g4tv.com/AOTS. There you can find links to everything you just saw. It's almost as fun as playing with it, honest.
I actually, my button unbuttoned in the middle of that from like boxing. I had to like kind of
really
tidy myself back
and knocked
up
the stuffing out of you. Is what
it
you
did
said.
A little bit.
Busted the guts.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm
it's
a pro.
New. Right now, folks, it is time for the only news that you need to know. So let me get Layla Kaylee with the feed headlines.
That doesn't work on a like that.
Thanks, guys. Here's what's coming up in the feed. First, the PS3 was officially launched in Japan, and we've got all the details. Plus, Borat takes the box office and also takes a beating. And air guitar fans might soon be able to rock out for real. It's all coming your way in the feed. But first, back to you guys.
All right. We know you folks at home have a ton of questions about the console war, so we should probably answer them.
Yep, it is time now to check in with you guys in the Army of Monitor Heads. Here is Juan from California.
We know which one's more expensive, but which one will have better games this Christmas, PS3 or the Wii?
That's the first shotgun question we've had.
I know.
A question asked from the shotgun position. Very nice.
I like it. Now, the PS3 is for hardcore gamers, and it's basically, it's like the PS3, it's like the PS2, but just looks better, it's faster, it's just
better
graphics.
If you like the games on the PS2, you're going to find them on the PS3.
But the Nintendo is a whole new breed. I mean, it's not, you can't even compare it to other consoles.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about this controller. So I think that's what you're going to find is that, at least on the Wii side of things, all the games, he wants to know about, you know, which game's going to be better. I mean, better or worse, it's really not fair. It's very apples and oranges. But these are going to be a little bit different, something that you haven't seen before, which is nice.
And aren't most PS3 titles already available on other systems? Like Call of Duty 3 is already out, so is Tony Hawk's Project 8. I mean, which you can't even take online with the PS3.
Yeah, and that's a valid argument. People say, well, you could get the 360, which is, you know, relatively half the price, and play some of those titles, which, at least right now, they pretty much look the same. There's nothing more amazing about the PlayStation 3. You know, I played a little Ridge Racer 7.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, Gundam not looking so hot.
Well, are there any big games for the PS3 that are coming out that you have to get?
A lot of people are saying Resistance Fall of Man is that game. And I've only spent milliseconds with it, so I'm not in any position to judge it. We'll have Adam on later in the show who's played it at length. He can tell you if it's really that good. But I'm definitely excited for the Wii. I think that, for me, the games are more exciting on that one, at least right now. So
much fun.
All right. Even though we have some questions about the PlayStation 3, we know it's going to sell out. Mm-hmm. People are already waiting in line. And this console war obviously is going to have a huge impact on the future of gaming. But really, do gamers want a sophisticated system with multiple applications, or do they just want to have some simple fun?
Well, we want to know what you guys think with today's poll question, PS3 versus Wii. Who will come out on top? Vote at our website, g4tv.com/AOTS, or text your vote to G4TXT, that's 44898, to vote and register for AOTS Live News Alerts.
Right now, coming up later, folks, you don't have to wait until next summer to get your first peek into the much-anticipated Spider-Man 3. We're going to have the brand-new trailer for the surefire blockbuster later in the show.
Now, Spider-Man 3 may be the most anticipated film of next summer, but right now on TV, it doesn't get much hotter than Lost. No. Sure, we have our doubts about where the series is headed, but you have to give credit to the writers for their web they've spun to hook all those viewers.
Yeah, and recently Attack of the Show was actually given exclusive access to the writers' room of Lost. It's the place where the elaborate mythologies and the storylines, it's where everything is created.
Did they shipwreck on the island like the Harlem Globetrotters did in Gilligan's Island?
Ooh, oh, there's great. A basketball.
The Harlem Globetrotters are not going to crash land on the island. Fourth all right, come on, come on, come on, come on, people. We need to focus here. We're working under the assumption that this week, the island is actually a giant ant farm being run by aliens.
Wasn't that last week?
No! Last week we worked under the assumption that it was a snow globe owned by an autistic girl.
Is there anything for Claire to do this week?
No!
No.
Okay, I'm just asking. Kate shouldn't have all the fun.
Hey, guys, I wrote a thread where Sawyer gets the drop on the others. And that's all I got.
Isn't your resume just a series of never-ending shows that just get smaller and smaller and smaller until eventually you'll die?
Obviously, you would simply have one of the others hold a gun to Kate's head and then Sawyer surrenders. We do it like every 2 weeks. You guys constantly overthink this. Kate gets captured very easily.
Good point. Good point.
Real quick, people. Just reasons why Hurley's fat. Go.
He's eating members of the tail section.
I like it. I like it.
Has anyone considered my idea that Locke and Echo are the same person?
We killed Echo, so I don't know what you want.
Dream sequence. Yeah.
Yes. Besides, we need to start pushing to ABC's new show, Black Man vs. Polar Bear. Mm-hmm. I guess it's been a ratings bonanza whenever we've had a polar bear attack a black man on the show.
Do we still have the suit?
The black man suit?
The polar bear suit.
The black man suit.
That's actually pretty funny.
They are very smart guys over there. Now, we will see if Lost continues to get high ratings for ABC and the network. Also has high hopes for Show Me the Money, starring William Shatner. Mm-hmm. ABC has been calling the game show Shat-tastic, Shat-rageous, and Shatterific. Which is your favorite Shat?
I don't know. For the captain's sake, I just hope it's not like some ABC show just Shat on my TV. That's my real concern, because that's looking like the fall lineup.
There's Shat all over your TV.
I'm tuning in. Stay with us. We'll be back.
It's console combat as the PS3 and Wii struggle for supremacy in the loop.
Welcome back to Attack of the Show. We are live and talking PlayStation 3 versus the Wii. Before the break, we asked you, PS3 versus Wii, who will come out on top? Well, most of you must be Nintendo fanboys, as 61% of you think Nintendo's Wii will top PlayStation 3. Let's go on over to Kevin, who, like the Wii, is both cheap and fun.
That is true. In just days, you can finally get your hands on Sony's PlayStation 3 and Nintendo's Wii. Now, the PS3 is trying to blow you away with graphics and its fancy cell processors. The Nintendo Wii, on the other hand, wants to offer you and your grandmother a totally new gaming experience. But who is going to come out on top? Welcome to the next level. I missed that. It's The Loop. Joining us tonight from San Francisco, senior editor for Games Radar, Christian Nutt is here, and contributor for Electronic Gaming Monthly, Johnny Gibson. Welcome to the Loop, gentlemen. Christian,
hello.
I want to start with you because it sounds like, I mean, Nintendo has everything going for it. We've heard for months now they've been producing these consoles. They're cheap. They've got the innovative controller. How can the PlayStation 3 stand a chance when even our own polls are reflecting the people think the Wii is going to win?
Well, the PlayStation had a lot of bad press, you know, going up to the launch, but it's a fantastic system with fantastic graphics. It's much more technologically advanced, and it should pave the way for 5, 6, maybe 10, as they want more years of gaming.
Now, do you really think that Sony will be able to get 10 years out of a console? I don't recall a manufacturer ever getting that much life out of a system, really.
Yeah, I don't know. It's difficult to say. It really depends on how things go with the 360, because obviously the Wii's paving a different path. I think they can coexist just fine, the PS3 and the Wii. It's all down to Sony versus MS.
That's true. Now, John, some people say that the Wii, at best, it's a slightly improved GameCube with a controller that's going to get gimmicky within seconds. I mean, is that a fair assessment?
It's a glorified GameCube, yeah. The graphics aren't up to par like PS3 or 360, but it's fun. Like, Christian doesn't mention the fun of Wii. PS3 has hair follicles with 20,000 polygons in it, but is there fun? Is there a community aspect to it?
But they flow naturally, John. That's the thing. Be it wind tunnel or just a casual sword fight, the hair flows naturally.
And they have pores and real-time pimples, but it doesn't matter because Nintendo knows.
It doesn't matter?
It does not matter.
I think it matters.
You think pores matter?
Did you know? I don't think pores matter. I think excellent graphics matter. These games transport you to different worlds, show you things you couldn't see, and at HD resolution. So I think it's going to be really hot.
But compare something like Gears of War. It's a Resistance. Like, there's no comparison there. Like, Gears has the simplified gameplay with that visceral action that you want, and
yeah,
Resistance
let's touch on Gears of War for a second, Christian, because when people go to the Best Buys and the Toys R Us's of the world and they see Gears of War next to the PlayStation 3, I mean, it's comparing a launch title, you know, lineup to a title
right.
that's had years in development. So some would say that's not fair, but does the average consumer know that or care? I mean, is the PlayStation 3 in trouble during its holiday launch season?
I don't know. I think that, you know, sure, there's been negative buzz on the net, but I think a lot of people love PlayStation. Gears of War has been lavished, you know, no expense spared. You know, I'd compare Resistance to, say, Perfect Dark Zero, see how we feel about that. They have to compete.
No,
that's a
much fairer comparison, yeah. And most people aren't willing to make that one. Now, John, do you compare the Wii to the PlayStation 3? Because you said it's all about fun for you, but can you compare the two types of games available?
I don't think necessarily it's that fair, but I spent the whole weekend with friends playing the Wii and hitting the Wii Sports and hitting the Zelda and doing some Excite Truck. And it's just fun. It's this community aspect of gameplay that we kind of lost. Like, remember the days of Super Mario Kart with Super Nintendo? Like, you had four friends in the living room, like, yelling at each other. And now you can strangle them with the cord, too.
I'm getting misty. No, you're supposed to use the included wrist strap, and again, don't hurt other people in the room. Nintendo's being very clear about that.
But it's all about the choking, Kevin. It's all about the choking.
I know you're a big fan of the choke, John. Christian, you know, people have said they're hoping to get 400,000 units to North America for this launch window. I mean, I think it's a no-brainer that this is going to be sold out. People won't be able to get their hands on it, even if they want it. But what's the outlook for, let's say, January through June of next year? Will the demand still be high for the PlayStation 3?
Well, I mean, let's look at how the 360 went. The 360 demand was consistent across last year. And, I mean, the PlayStation, people love the PlayStation. I think the demand is going to outstrip supply for some good long time, especially as better games start coming out early next year. We're talking like Heavenly Sword and Warhawk, Reign, all those games that people are really looking forward to that use the six-axis controller, you know, stuff like that.
But is it $600, $800? Like you need the system that bad when you got the Wii for $300 with a game, basically?
Yeah, that's, I mean, they're very different. It is a lot of money, but it's delivering a very high, you know, technological appeal.
It's an
like
investment that could pay
thing.
Off down the road, and I think that's the risk that Sony's hoping
I think it will,
people
you know?
are willing to make. And I agree, I think it will as well. But right now, though, it's a question of who's going to win, but I don't think we're going to answer that just yet today. I want to thank Christian and John for keeping us in the loop. Listen, the battle of the PlayStation 3 versus the Wii is not going to be decided by fancy processors or gimmicky controllers. The battle will be decided by whoever has the most innovative and entertaining games. And remember, the console war debate, well, it doesn't end here. All this week, we're going to be chatting gaming in the loop, but right now we're going to our own motion-sensitive Mun.
Thanks, Kev. Today we are bringing you tomorrow's biggest album releases. It is time again to attack this. First up, for you Neil Young fans out there, Live at the Fillmore East is a six-track concert album originally recorded in 1970 that has finally made its way out of Neil's archives. The album features talented guitarist Danny Whitten, who died of a drug overdose just 2 years later. Anyone interested in learning where the garage band movement started should make this a part of their collection. Download Everybody Knows This Is Nowhere. Next, The Game follows up his multi-platinum debut album with Doctor's Advocate. The title is a nod to Dr. Dre, the man who discovered the artist, who's been credited with single-handedly bringing back the West Coast scene. There's plenty of special guests on Doctor's Advocate, including hip-hop all-stars like Nas, Snoop Dogg, and Kanye West. Download One Blood. Next is the album 9 from Ireland's Damien Rice. It's like John Mayer music for people who aren't D-bags. Plus, it's dorm room tested. Play it on full blast, and we guarantee that girls will throw their panties at you because, you know, you're just a sensitive guy. Download 9 Crimes. And for when the girls aren't around, we suggest you ditch the Damien Rice and crank some Tenacious D, the pick of destiny. Jack Black and Kyle Gass team up for the soundtrack to the upcoming movie of the same name. It works as a concept album and tells the tale of how Jack and Kyle teamed up to form the greatest band in the world. It's not as good as their debut album, but it comes close. Listen for cameos by Dave Grohl, Meatloaf, and the legendary Ronnie James Dio. Download History. That's today's Attack This. Visit g4tv.com/AOTS for links to all these albums. Still ahead, we'll have more PS3 launch news in the feed, and we're debuting a new blogging feature. All that and more on TV's only source for all the stuff you care about.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Attack of the Show. What are we?
We're TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. Not like right. The second or the third. We're the only
one. No, the only source. So
yeah,
you're lucky you're here.
You guys are lucky, and you guys are lucky that we are live and ready to surf our way through text.
Yeah, that's right. The blogosphere is sort of the internet's version of water cooler chat. You know, anything and everything's being discussed online. And with the increasing popularity of the medium, we felt that it was our civic duty, really, to fill you in on the more interesting blogs out there.
Time for some online personality. Here is Blog Search. First up, there's Make Blog. This is the blog for ultimate do-it-yourself projects. There are tons of directions on how to make quirky things at home, including a yacht made out of toothpicks, and info about how to build your own Mac home media center. Every weekend podcaster Bree Pettis, who we actually had on the show a few weeks ago, does a special video podcast. Past projects include how to make shadow puppets and my personal favorite, the vegetable projectile gun. Take a look at this super enhanced spud gun.
The pump gazooka.
Just like the spud gun, the taser totter, I've sharpened up the front of this pump gazooka and I used ABS cement to cement it all together. And then I drilled holes that were 1564ths, which is just a little bit smaller. All right, so that wraps up another weekend project.
Did he kill a dolphin on that last one? It sounded like I heard Flipper out there.
I know. What would be great if you just had a friend out there. I like when people hurt their friends.
I got a dude in an inner tube. You're just trying to hit him with pineapples.
Oh my gosh, what a great game!
I got a new game.
That sounds awesome. I know that you go onto this.
It makes me realize how untalented and really incapable I am when it comes to anything. Incapable,
really?
I guess would be. Yeah, because I see all these cool artsy like craft electronic kind of hacks and circuit bending things that these guys do, and I can't do a single one of them. But they did have an LED throwy thing, which was.
Did you try to do that?
Yeah, I did. I made a couple, actually.
Wow.
It was like a couple bucks at Radio Shack. It was like a fun hour on a Saturday when I was alone contemplating
that was
suicide.
The one thing?
Yeah, and I went and did it.
Contemplating suicide?
Yeah.
Why didn't you go through with it?
Because they had the LED throwies.
Oh, stupid website.
I know.
Okay, if you guys are on the hunt for what can only be called modern art, look no further than WeMakeMoneyNotArt.com. This group of bloggers puts together the latest in new media and technological art and function, like the wearable instrument shirt that you can actually play like a guitar,
yeah,
and a functioning cell phone made from an old landline. Can you say pretty much awesome?
Because
I think
you can.
Now, you got onto this, too. These are sites that
Yeah,
you
I
like
love
too.
All these. I hit the site, like, every day, and it is hit or miss at times, but you'll find really cool underground artists. And what's great is that they spot the interesting things, cool art exhibits, or neat people that are making the art themselves. They find it before other people seem to.
So once you hear about it, it's been on there like a week before.
Yeah, just know that the cool kids found it there first.
Like you? Cool kids?
Yeah. And the coolest people let you know how cool they are incessantly by letting you know that they saw something before you did.
By making
people
sure they get a national cable television show where they're on every day.
Yeah, seen it. No big deal.
I would never do that. And last but not least, TV can be weird anywhere. But if you want a taste of the truly, truly bizarre, check out TVinJapan.com. The site includes various clips from Japanese television, including Japanese versions of the PS3 and Mac commercials. The About section of the site states that this is one fool who loves him some TV in Japan. Oh, and there's also this awesome, awesome video of a robot performing a traditional Japanese dance.
Thank you.
beautiful.
I was hoping for some like Euro techno to kick in, and then they actually start. Like you got the geishas doing
the
robot.
Even the geishas?
Yeah, that would have been.
Okay,
cool.
Let's try it right now. No, wait, we go into it.
Okay, so we're doing. Okay, see, I don't even know what this is here.
No, you have to go into techno now.
And then some oil squirts.
I do a great robot. All right, everyone.
Why did I just do that with you?
I think I'm, because you love me. I'm logged out for the day. So for more info and links to all these sites, check out g4tv.com/AOTS. And you guys, do not chicken out on us and tune away now. We will be back like Marty McFly. See you in a bit.
The news just got better. It's the feed. And sometimes you play too hard. That's why we're giving you a game break.
Everybody, welcome back. We are live and pimping out all the stuff you care about.
Mm-hmm. Coming up later, we are showing you the new trailer for Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 3. Tobey Maguire is back as the amazing masked web slinger. And later in the show, we are showing you him in action. Black suit Spider-Man, that's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. He's getting down. But right now, it's time for the only news that you need to know in the feed.
Thanks, guys. I'm Layla Cayley, and it's time to start the feed. On Saturday, Japan was the first country to get its hands on the PS3. Despite chaotic crowds and long lines, consumers finally were able to purchase the console. At least 89,000 PS3s have been sold so far. The top games were Ridge Racer 7, a mobile suit, Gundam, Target, and Sight. Approximately 30,000 of each were sold. Expect even more chaos here. The US is only getting 400,000 units. Once again, Far Out was the number one film at the box office this weekend. It took in an estimated $29 million, easily beating the competition. Though despite all the success, Far Out isn't loved by everyone. After Sacha Baron Cohen appeared on Saturday Night Live a couple of weeks ago, he went out onto the street in character and messed with strangers. Not getting the joke, one man slugged Cohen in the face several times. Thankfully, host Hugh Laurie was there and managed to rescue the actor. A new video posted on YouTube has sparked a huge controversy. Cop Watch LA, a watchdog group that targets the LAPD, has posted a video of two officers repeatedly punching an alleged gang member during an arrest. The video was captured on a camera phone, and the file was subsequently uploaded to the site. Since the video has been available, it has been viewed almost a million times. The FBI is now investigating the incident. And finally, if you can't play guitar and can't handle Guitar Hero, the answer to your problems might be here. A doctor has invented a t-shirt which enables you to hear the notes you're mimicking. Electronic sensors woven into the material transmits your movements by radio to a nearby computer where it's converted into music. There's no word when the shirt will be available, though it could have many more uses. And yes, one of them is playing video games. Well, that's all for today. You can now get the Feed 2 Go on your iPod. Visit the iTunes store, go to g4tv.com/podcast and click on iTunes Podcast to subscribe. Now, you've just been fed. Back to you guys. Okay, thanks, Layla. Lots more ahead here on Attack of the Show, including
you're
sights.
Right,
you make me laugh during breaks.
What
during
I do.
The feed, during the breaks, just all the time.
Just a big giggle fest.
Okay, you guys, there are things so horrific. The Elephant Man shies away.
Yes.
I swear, that's true.
We have lots more deformities and defamations ahead on TV's only source for all the stuff that makes you giggle.
It's so funny.
It's the giggle.
They fire their accusations, but we settle the score on Game Break. It's up.
Attack of the show, attack. Attack of the show, attack.
Welcome back to Attack of the Show Live and living it up in the gaming world. So right now, let's get some hot coffee with Mr. Kevin Pereira.
I do loves me some coffee, Olivia. I like it hot and black. But never mind, it's time to make sense of the gaming stories that matter the most. Pause your Gears of War co-op matches, okay, put the controller aside because it's time for today's Game Break. Here to discuss all things gaming, co-host of X-Play, the expert himself, Adam Sessler. How are you, sir?
I'm doing all right. And you?
Good weekend of gaming. I had a great one.
Pretty much, this is the only thing that's happening that's not involving Gears of War right now.
All right, well, let's get into it. We're going to get to Gears, but I want to start first with something that Nolan Bushnell said. Recently, he sat down with a media company, Red Herring, for an interview, and when asked about the PlayStation 3, the former president of Atari, I think he was the founder, had more than a few words of wisdom for Sony and its upcoming console launch. In the interview, Nolan Bushnell says, quote, "Sony has shot themselves in the foot. There is a high probability they will fail. For years, Sony has been a very difficult company to deal with from a developer standpoint." This is Nolan Bushnell.
Yeah, he also, I think, as we're saying, called them arrogant and capricious.
And he said that they could be that because they had such a huge installation base with the PlayStation 2 that they could treat developers however they want. And did that game change? Is this still the case with Sony?
I'm afraid that Sony still behaves this way. I mean, it's a lot of it just... You know, there's so much about what's happening now that's very similar to what happened at the launch of the PS2.
Right.
You have cutbacks on the number of all these big promises that don't seem to be delivered on. The big one being 400,000 down from 2 million is very significant.
Sure.
I think like the high cost. And it really does seem like that developers are getting some of the same difficulties that they had at the launch of the PS2. The PS2 launch was I remember hearing from a lot of developers that they weren't getting the support. They couldn't figure out how to work the architecture.
Neversoft couldn't get their game online because they don't have the online libraries.
I know.
Is this Sony being rude and being arrogant, as Bushnell would say, or is it they simply don't have their act together?
I think there's two different ways. There are ways in the position that I'm in. I feel that I have dealt with Sony sort of arrogance that you know, there's certain facets of the press out there that they would just assume not deal with.
Right.
Though I think also it's a very big company.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that from the development of the PS2, and I imagine this is also similar for the PS3, you have a Japanese and American division. Guess what? They're not always in agreement with one another.
Sure.
And it's that big and kind of unwieldy.
Sometimes Sony America doesn't even know what announcements are coming out of Sony.
I mean, the idea of the city going like, oh, let's give those developers a hard time and make the product suffer. I don't think they're saying that. At the same time, I think that it's a large bureaucracy and they can't get the kind of support that I think some of the other game companies do offer.
All right. Next up is the general manager from EA Montreal. Okay, so he was while speaking about at the panel at the Montreal Game Summit, he shared his thoughts on the Xbox 360 and the little title called Gears of War that we've been chatting about. He said he thinks Gears has been overrated and that the title is lacking in terms of any real innovation. So now, of course, gamers are up in arms, especially when it's an EA employee talking about lack of innovation.
Yeah,
but
he's from Montreal.
Yeah.
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 Pot kettle black, or is he right? Is this true? Like, there's no innovation.
Okay,
to be found,
I know one thing. Gears of War is hella fun.
Yeah.
It's one of the best times I've had with the game. I do think, on some level, it's innovative. When you take a step back, you're like, okay, I am kind of doing the same thing over and over again. Mm. But when you're in the
that
thick
thing
of
you're
it,
doing in that
it's,
moment.
Yes, and it's so well thought out. I don't know. It depends what people consider to be innovation. Mm-hmm. It still has a lot of trappings with traditional games, which I think is fine. I think I don't know what people keep on thinking that they want from innovation.
Sure.
In terms of the game that I think might break more boundaries, BioWare's Mass Effect is what I'm currently thinking might really be that one. But that's not
but
to
with
the
all that
discredit
said, and very,
of Gears of War.
Very quickly here. Is the chainsaw kill perhaps not the most satisfying way to defeat an enemy in any video game ever created?
You know Rumsfeld's going, oh, I should have thought of that one. I would still have my job.
He would, too.
Yeah, the chainsaw kill, wow.
The curb stomp as
well.
Sessler, thank you for coming on
my
and chatting video games. Folks, we will continue covering the hottest gaming stories every Monday right here on The Game Break. But make sure you tune in. You got to check out XPlay's exclusive PlayStation 3 preview show. Adam Sessler will be there along with Morgan Webb. It's coming up right after Attack of the Show here on G4. For more information, you can check out g4tv.com/xplay. But right now, it's Miss Olivia's turn.
Now, as all you gamers out there know, this Friday, the PS3 will finally be available, and G4 will be your only source for all the excitement with our three-hour exclusive special, PS3 Day 1. It kicks off with a two-hour Attack of the Show special, followed by must-see episodes of X-Play and Cheat. Buckle up, because we are giving you live demos of Full Auto 2 and Resistance Fall of Man. Zach will be reporting from the PS3 New York City launch party, and we'll have an exclusive interview with the president of Sony himself, Kaz Hirai. Now, from the Blu-ray to reviews to strategy tips, join Kevin, Adam Sessler, Morgan Webb, Kristen Holt, Will, Zach, Layla, and I as we show you the future of gaming. It all starts next Friday right here on G4 from 6 to 9. And for more information, head on over to g4tv.com/ps3. Now, when we come back, we are talking to James Bond about Casino Royale. Throw it all on black and let it spin. Stay with us.
Welcome back, everybody. Now, this weekend, probably the only man who's going to be able to dethrone Borat at the box office is going to be James Bond. And we've got a first look at what you've got in store.
After stupid crap like invisible cars and buildings made of ice, Bond is going back to basics. We talked to the new 007 Daniel Craig, the Bond girls, and others about Casino Royale.
Am I going to have a problem with you, Bond?
No, don't worry. You're not my type.
Bond is back. And in movie number 21, Casino Royale, we have a new mission, new Bond girls, and a brand new Bond.
You noticed. The bad guys in this movie are trying to destabilize the world's economy because they want to take over, and they're using money and terrorism to do this.
The man was Le Chiffre, private banker to the world's terrorists.
He's laundering money for terrorist organizations. Doesn't have a political agenda himself. He doesn't really care as long as he makes some money.
Do you believe in God, Mr. Le Chiffre?
No. I believe in a reasonable rate of return.
And it ends up that he has to go and play him at cards because this guy's a compulsive gambler and is using people's money to try and double his own money.
The latest 007 gets to take the character back to Bond basics.
He's only just got his license. And it really goes right back to the beginning, his first mission. But he doesn't become 007, the character that we know and love, until the last frame of the movie.
I knew it was too early to promote you.
Well, I understand 00s have a very short life expectancy. I wanted to sort of get a balance between the action and the story. And I wanted to sort of make sure that we saw a sort of fallibility in the character so that we could sort of understand and try and engage a bit more.
And what better way to explore that fallibility than with the Bond girls?
I'm the money.
Every penny of it.
She's full of secrets and... And she's also very, very strong, very tough, you know, very sassy.
I'm Mr. Arlington Beach, professional gambler, and you're Miss Stephanie Broadchester, heiress.
I am not.
You're going to have to trust me on this.
Oh, no, I don't.
For the first time, the women, they're not complete idiots, I think so. And you don't understand if they're good or the bad. And I think the good and the bad, the angel and the devil, they are mixed completely in this movie.
I'm afraid I'm not that cruel.
Well, perhaps you just had a practice.
Although the man in the tux may have changed, you can still count on the fact that the action, women, and awesomeness that is 007 hasn't.
I think Ian Fleming sort of created this guy who's bad, who's charming, who's sophisticated. It's created a legacy.
Long live James Bond. Casino Royale opens this Friday nationwide, but more importantly, it opens in Bolivia on Christmas.
It's a landlocked country, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Still coming up, we've got the new trailer for Spider-Man 3, the alien suit, the Hobgoblin, Kirsten Dunst. Oh, wait, no, that's two different characters. Sandman, it's all up next on TV's only source for all the stuff you care about.
You haven't been watching Attack of the Show? This is what you're missing. For more info, go to g4tv.com/AOTS.
Hey!
What was that? Let them in on what they just missed. What was that part? The blah blah blah.
We sometimes do a little bit of a web thing from Kevin's home, and we don't know the name of it yet. So it's like Olivia and
Kevin's
fun time on Wednesday nights, and watch us from Kevin's apartment. So we're coming up with new things.
Hey, everybody, welcome to the show. Attack of the Show. We're live, and last night I curb-stomped an 11-year-old.
I'm guessing you played Gears of War during the whole Emergence Day event then, right?
No. Not even play Gears yesterday.
So
coming up tomorrow, we've got a brand new DV Doomsday. We'll check out the Strangers with Candy flick, find out who killed the electric car, and even, we'll have the longer version of King Kong. Did someone really ask for that?
I would never have asked for that.
No.
It was pretty damn long in the beginning.
Yeah.
Now, we'll also go in your pants for the sex relationship advice that will keep you relatively normal. And on Wednesday, we'll show you some ladies into peace, love, and top eights. We're trolling the web for hippies and are going to crown a new MySpace girl of the week.
Totally. Finally, though, it's time for the further adventures of everyone's favorite web slinger.
It is the trailer for Spider-Man 3. Peter Parker's back, and he is pissed.
ask MJ to marry me.
A man has to put his wife before himself. Can you do that, Peter?
Yeah, I think I can.
We have some new information. This is your uncle's actual killer. We lost his trail 2 days ago.
This man killed my uncle, and he's still out there.
Everybody needs help sometimes, Peter. Even Spider-Man.
Revenge is like a poison. It can take us over. And before you know it, it can turn you into something ugly.
The suit. Where'd this come from? The power. Feels good. You lose yourself to it.
Whoa.
Spidey, love the new outfit.
Remember Ben Parker?
What does it matter to you anyway?
Everything.
Do you want to push me away?
Why would I want to push you away? I love you.
You knew this was coming, Pete.
I didn't kill your father.
We have to forgive each other, or everything we ever were will mean nothing.
I need your help. I have to stop it.
This could be the end of Spider-Man.
Yes!
Okay, is Tobey Maguire not the most awesome Spider-Man ever?
Oh, that's what I'm talking about.
I can't wait. I love the black suit.
The third movie in any franchise or series of films is always supposed to be like the death knell, but this looks like it could be the best one.
It looks like the best one.
There's that shot of like pressing Sandman's face against the subway train when it comes by. It's always been like a fetish. I wanted to try it when I was in Japan. I just never got the chance to, but now I see what it looks like, and it looks awesome.
I liked when he punched through him, and he was all sand.
Dude's all sand.
God, I love that movie. Now, for all the things you guys saw today and more, go to g4tv.com/AOTS.
Yes, but remember to stick around for X-Play's PlayStation 3 preview show with Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb. It's going to happen right now.
Right now.
But like, right now, like in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There it is!